Okay, sorry guys, let's do this again. So the cranial nerve palsies of ophthalmology. So we're going to start with third nerve. So I just told you third nerve, your oculomotor nerve is going to supply all the extraocular muscles except lateral rectus and superior oblique. So that is lateral rectus, LR6 and SO4, right? So lateral rectus is supplied by the sixth nerve and superior oblique by the fourth nerve. Now, apart from these extraocular muscles, your third nerve supplies LPS, okay? That is your levator palpebrae superioris. So what happens when we have a third nerve palsy? The only muscles that are going to remain is going to be your superior oblique and lateral rectus. So you know lateral rectus is attached on this side of the eyeball. So it's going to be abduction that is going to happen to the eyeball, okay, because everything else is gone. So the lateral rectus that is preserved, yes, because it's abducens supplying it, is going to take the eyeball out, and the superior oblique, which is supplied by trochlear nerve, is also going to be preserved. So superior oblique is primarily a depressor muscle, so my eyeball is going to be down and out, out because of lateral rectus and down because of superior oblique. So now the deviation in third nerve palsy will be a down and out deviation. So let's imagine my right third nerve palsy. So my right eye is down and out. My left eye is normal. So now my patient has diplopia because the left eye is looking straight. My right eye is looking elsewhere. So I have diplopia. So I've got my first D, the down and out deviation, and I've got diplopia, right? Now, what is the next D? The levator palpebrae superioris, which is supposed to raise your lid, is not working. So definitely now there's going to be drooping of eyelids, which I call the third D, drooping of lids. Now, the parasympathetic impulses are also coming into the eye through the third nerve. Pulse goes to the sphincter muscle. So my sphincter is not going to work when I have a third nerve palsy. So what is the other muscle? The antagonist muscle, my sphincter opposite dilator muscle. So my dilator is going to overact, resulting in a dilated pupil, right? So now I've got my four Ds, down and out deviation of eyeball, I've got diplopia, I've got drooping of lids, that is ptosis because of LPS, and now I've also got dilatation of pupil, all right? Third nerve palsy, is that simple? Now, we have something called pupil sparing third nerve palsy. That means the pupil is spared where I don't have dilatation of pupil. Where do I not have this dilatation of pupil? It's going to be in case of diabetes causing the third nerve palsy. Typically, diabetes causing third nerve palsy. So that's your other MCQ, pupil sparing third nerve palsy. I don't know what's the difficulty about this. It's very, very simple, right? Third nerve palsy, down and out deviation, because what is left? Superior oblique, which is primarily a so depressed down and lateral rectus working, so out, all right? So down and out deviation in third nerve palsy with ptosis because my LPS is gone and dilated pupil. Now, when do I not have dilatation of pupil? Especially in case of diabetes mellitus, that's a very typical MCQ for you. Now, coming to fourth nerve palsy. Fourth nerve palsy, your superior oblique palsy. Now, superior oblique palsy, your compensatory head posture is important. Yes, compensatory head posture is important. Why? Because if I have a superior oblique palsy, definitely I'm going to have diplopia. And to avoid that particular diplopia, I'm going to take in a compensatory head posture. See, just for example, now if my shoulder is paining, I'm not going to sleep on my right side shoulder. Correct? Right side, I'm not going to sleep because I have pain here. I'm going to avoid this. So similarly, I adopt something called a compensatory head posture to avoid that diplopia. So what is that compensatory head posture? In superior oblique palsy, it will always be a head tilt to the opposite shoulder. Okay, head tilt to the opposite shoulder. So we're going to keep this video very, very simple things here. So when I have a right superior oblique palsy, I have a head tilt to the opposite shoulder. That means I'll have a head tilt to the left shoulder. All right, simple. Now, if I have a sixth nerve palsy, my sixth nerve is going to supply only one muscle, lateral rectus. So my lateral rectus is not working, correct? Which is this antagonist muscle, the medial rectus. So one muscle is not working, the antagonist muscle is going to overact. So my medial rectus will overact, causing a right eye to converge. So I get a right convergent squint, which I call right esotropia. So when I have a right lateral rectus palsy, or let me say I have a right abducens nerve palsy, I'm going to have a right esotropia. Eso means inside, okay? And supposing I have a left lateral rectus palsy, my left lateral rectus is not working, so my medial rectus is going to overact, so I'm going to have a left esotropia. So that's very simple, okay? So either it's a right convergence point in right lateral rectus palsy or a right abducens palsy, or it's going to be a left lateral rectus palsy or a left abducens palsy, you're going to have a left esotropia. I hope I'm clear on this. So now when I have an esotropia, again I'm going to have diplopia. So what do? I take a, now let's say I have a right lateral rectus palsy. So my right eye, I have a convergence squint. So I'm going to turn my face to the same side so that both the eyes become parallel and I no longer have diplopia. So what is my compensatory head posture here? I have a face turn or a head turn to the same side, right? So in case of a right lateral rectus palsy, face turn or a right head turn. And for the left lateral rectus palsy, I'm going to have a left face turn or a left head turn. Okay, it's always going to be to the same side, lateral rectus palsy. Now, some of you just overthink and ask, ma'am, medial rectus palsy, what will happen? Hey, come on, yeah, you know, it's going to be a very rare condition where the nerve to medial rectus alone is going to be affected and you're going to have a medial rectus palsy. Because we are going to talk only about in terms of third nerve palsy, which is going to affect all the extraocular muscles except lateral rectus and superior oblique. So don't worry, don't fray your nerves thinking about what happens in superior rectus palsy, what happens in inferior oblique palsy. Don't worry about that. Don't worry about that. Just think third nerve palsy, what is the deviation? It's a down and out deviation. In lateral rectus palsy, what is the deviation? It's an inward deviation. It's an esotropia. It's Y head tilt to opposite side in SO palsy. Okay, I'll give you a very, very easy answer for that. Now, what is your primary action of superior oblique? Primary action of superior oblique is intorsion, right? My right side, superior oblique, intorsion, correct? So let's just keep it that way. You're not doing MS ophthalmology. You only have to arrive at your answer. I'll give you clues to arrive at the answer, right? Already tiring Thursday, so we're just going to keep it simple. So right superior oblique, intorsion. Now this intorsion is not happening. So I'm going to do some compensatory movement, simulate to something similar to this movement. So right intorsion, can I do my head tilt like this? Yes, got a head tilt like this. Yes, Gaurav, I hope you got your answer. So I've got a right superior oblique palsy, right intorsion. I'm tilting my head to the left because my left superior oblique again intorsion this way. So I'm doing a left head tilt to the left shoulder. I hope that is over. So that is all I'm going to talk about today. Hey, I've done it. Go watch it again. Okay, I got to go, guys. Right? Sorry, ma'am, by mistake, this smiley. Okay, you smile, you laugh, whatever. Right, bye. If you have any doubts, just put it in the comment box. I'll check it a little later.